We all want and like mailbox money, but what is mailbox money? Things like Social Security, pensions, annuity income, real estate income, all those things would be considered mailbox money. It's a consistent stream of income. You don't have to worry about it. But here's the problem. Most mailbox money isn't inflation adjusted. And that's why having too much mailbox money may be detrimental to your retirement plan. You see, things like pensions oftentimes are the same at age 65 as they are at age 85. The amount did not go up. Same thing with annuity payments. Social Security does have a cost of living adjustment, but of course we know it's not very much. It could be 1 or 2% per year. And so it's very important that you balance your overall portfolio and income stream in some growth assets that have the ability to outpace inflation while balancing that with some mailbox money for security. And the best thing to do is to create a portfolio that's diversified where you can pull some of that income off each month and create your own mailbox money while the corpus still continues to grow. So again, make sure you have this proper balance. People tend to pay an enormous price for comfort. And what that means is they will sacrifice returns and overall growth in their net worth just to have mailbox money. And we all want it, it all feels good. But again, as time goes on, I've seen it time and time again, there creates this large gap between somebody's monthly expenditures and what they're receiving each month. And what they receive each month tends to be pretty flat, and their expenditures, as we know, continue to go up. And that's why you hear so many people say, I'm on a fixed income. I'm having trouble meeting my monthly expenditure needs. So before you run out and get too much mailbox money, look at your overall portfolio. You may need a comprehensive retirement plan to put all this into perspective, to take in consideration taxes, returns, and what that income stream really does need to be and how much of it needs to be inflation adjusted versus not. Hope this was helpful.